Tear gas, and chlorine gas, and mustard gas.
And the second question is, what did gases do to people on World War I?
The tear gas would cause irritation to people's skin. Chlorine gas could cause burning and irritation. Mustard gas could cause damage to your lungs, and any of them could kill you.
So how do people protect themselves from like those damages? What do you think?
The soldiers protected themselves with using the gas mask.
Yes. Can you give us your own opinion of how do people still survive with those kind of damages, gases that affect many people's lives?
I would think if it didn't kill them right there in the war, then it would have some long-term effects on their health. What do you think?
I would agree with Ms. Cordova and also hope that there would be some type of medical assistance for the soldiers who might have had impact by gases.
And what can you tell us about how the energy started with the gases? What do you know about who started it?
I think the French first used the gas, but they blamed it on Germany. But it was really the French. What do you think?
I agree.
Okay. And did you know that? Well, in the end, America and Germany, they became allies, and what can you tell us about it?
Do you know anything about America being an ally in Germany?
Nope.
I don't think I reviewed that part very well for this interview. Yeah, I don't know either.
Well, what else can you tell us about me? What you know, in your own words?
There were probably over 140 officers and other soldiers who were killed by the chlorine gas that they used in World War I.
And I think after time, some of the soldiers might have found fragmentations from some of the gases or the shells that included the gases in parts of their bodies, so there's probably long-term effects well after the war was done.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much.